Hello everyone, in today's session we'll be learning about the x-rays of the head and neck region. Okay, so here we can see a plain x-ray, posterior anterior view of the skull region. Okay, so we can see the frontal bone, the temporal bone, the other facial bones with the upper jaw, the lower jaw, all these are visible. Okay, and in head and neck x-rays, most of the times you are asked to identify the black shadows which are visible. Okay, there are some paranasal air sinuses. Okay, there are four of them. There is a frontal air sinus, the maxillary air sinus, ethmoid and the sphenoidal air sinus. Okay, out of which three can be visible in this view. We can see here in the frontal bone, this is the frontal air sinus. In the region of the nose, there is the ethmoidal air sinus. Then lateral to the nasal cavity, here is the maxillary air sinus. Okay, and this black shadow is not of the any air sinus, it is of the orbit. Okay, the orbital margins are visible here. Okay, then this white shadow that we can see here, that is actually the petrous part of the temporal bone, the hardest part of the skull, which will give a radio opaque shadow. Okay, then this is the maxilla with the upper tooth, the mandible with the lower tooth. Okay, so all these are visible in this plane skiagram. Okay, let's see another view of the plane skiagram. This view is referred to as lateral view. Okay, so this is a plain x-ray lateral view of the skull which is seen. Okay, so again the bones of the skull, the frontal, parietal, occipital, then white part here is again the petrous part of temporal bone, the maxilla, upper jaw, the mandible, the lower jaw, all these are visible. Okay, and again look at the black shadows which are visible here. This air sinus is very important in this lateral view. This is referred to as sphenoidal air sinus. Okay, this was not visible in the PA view or the AP view. Okay, in the lateral view this is very clear, and here is the region of frontal air sinus, and here is the region of ethmoidal, and here is the region of maxillary air sinus. Okay, and we can see some black shadow here. This is actually the mastoid air cells which are there. Okay, that is giving a black shadow in this region. Okay, so this is the lateral view of the skull. Then to see the paranasal air sinuses in much more detail, some special views are taken. One of those views is this is referred to as occipitomental view, also referred to as Waters view. Okay, we can see little bit mouth is opened, so that's why the black shadow is visible here. The air sinuses are little bit more clear here. This maxillary air sinus is looking very clear here. Then again the frontal air sinus, ethmoidal air sinus. Okay, so some additional views may be taken for better location of the paranasal air sinuses. Okay, and here in this region we can see one bone here, that's the odontoid process of the second cervical vertebrae. Okay, so this was about the skull. Okay, then in head and neck we can see this is the cervical vertebrae. Okay, this is plane skiagram lateral view of the cervical vertebrae, and this is AP view. Okay, we can see the cervical vertebrae in an AP view as well as the lateral view. Here try to identify the number of the cervical vertebrae. This is the first cervical vertebrae, this is second, third, fourth, fifth, sixth and seventh. Okay, this is the seventh cervical vertebrae which has got a bony prominence, that is referred to as the bony prominence of the seventh cervical vertebra is referred to as vertebra prominence. Okay, so all the cervical vertebrae can be identified here. And in this AP view, just try to appreciate this black air shadow which is visible. Okay, that black air shadow is of trachea. Okay, the tracheal air shadow can be seen here. Okay, then we have one more x-ray of this cervical vertebrae in a lateral view. Here again we can identify all the seven cervical vertebrae. This is the first one, the second one has got a broad spinous process, this is the third, fourth, fifth, sixth and the seventh. Okay, seventh will have the longest horizontal spinous process. Okay, then there is one contrast skiagram. Okay, look at the contrast material, where is it present. Here we can see a contrast material in a blood vessel. Which blood vessel is this? Yes, this is the internal carotid artery. Okay, internal carotid artery ultimately terminates into this anterior cerebral artery, middle cerebral artery. That area of distribution is visible here. Okay, if it would have been a vertebral artery, then this area of distribution will not be seen. Okay, and vertebral artery passes through the foramen transverse area of the cervical vertebrae, and the caliber would be slightly thin. Okay, and in this x-ray, look at the S-shaped turn which is happening here. This S-shaped turn is referred to as carotid siphon. Okay, this helps to dampen the pressure of the blood which is coming from the aorta. Okay, so carotid artery to be identified here, the internal carotid artery, and additional viva questions may be tell about the branches of the internal carotid artery. The fourth part of internal carotid artery here has got five branches. Okay, so which are those five branches? A branch to the eye is referred to as ophthalmic artery. Then two branches we covered, the anterior cerebral, the middle cerebral. Then there is posterior communicating artery and the anterior choroidal artery. Okay, all these are the branches. Okay, so in this x-ray you have to identify the internal carotid artery and viva may be related to it. Okay, so this was about the head and neck x-rays. Okay, thank you.